So I've mentioned BP YTOP on this channel as one of my favorite system monitoring utilities in Linux, and it still is to this day. I use it on a daily basis when I'm rendering, when I'm doing anything, if I need to kill any tasks, anything like that. Overall, it is a beautiful application. And it did start off from its humble beginnings as BashTOP right here. You can see the GitHub page for that. And this is the page for BP YTOP. And yes, I have covered BP YTOP a couple different times on this channel, but this is a little nice because BP YTOP has been rewritten in C++. What this is going to do is let it be just a little bit quicker overall because it's not really going to be using the Python code anymore. And over here, this is the actual GitHub page for BTOP++, the rewritten version of BP YTOP. Under here, you have a lot of different information that you are going to want to read through in regards to this application. And you can see as of September 18th, which was yesterday, the Linux version for BTOP++ is complete, released as version 1.0.0. And there was a bug fix, so the current version is actually 1.0.1. And we can see the development plan, including Mac OS X support, and eventually at version 1.3 he's aiming to have support for GPU monitoring. We can see right here as the same description, resource monitor that shows usage, stats of processor, memory, disks, network, and processes, the C++ version, and continuation of BashTOP and BP YTOP. And then we have a whole slew of features here that we could go over, but we're gonna talk a little bit about these when we actually jump into the application here, including my favorite thing. Honestly, I use it as stock and I just kind of use it to monitor and occasionally kill tasks here and there, so I'm not really getting to the nitty gritty of it, but I do love the ability to select themes and all that, and we're going to shuffle through those. He has a sponsor page if you're interested in funding the project. He has prerequisites here, including what your terminal is going to need to support and your locales and fonts. And then right here we have a notice with different text rendering issues and other things you may run into. And then we have all of our screenshots. Now for the installation of this, I tried to do it with just the install sh within the release download, but I ran into an issue. But doing the compiling it, it worked perfectly fine. My Arch system, I already had all these dependencies. I just did the git clone the repository, cd'd into it, ran make sudo make install. And then you're going to want to run sudo make setuid just to make sure that it runs properly with all the proper permissions and everything like that. So with all that said, let's go ahead and get this out of here and bring this in here. If it will let me. There we go. So this right here is BTOP. If I go ahead and hit escape and quit out of here, you can see this was the installation process I was running. Let's zoom in a little bit so we all can see it just a little bit better. I checked for some of those dependencies. I did the clone, ran make, and basically did everything we were just talking about. This is what it will look like when you run the installation process correctly. And then to get back into it, we just run BTOP, enter, and here we are. Now this isn't the default theme. So what we can do is go over here to menu. And you don't have to click, I'm a mouse person, you can just hit M, options, and use the keyboard to do basically everything. But you can see I'm on the 15th out of 15th theme that is pre-installed. If I go back, you can see all the different colors we have, including a flat white remix, so you can see what that looks like. It doesn't look good to me, so we'll go over to options. Let's the one I was really cool, they have Nord, which follows the Nordic color scheme, which is magnificent to me. But I was really liking the Dracula color scheming. And we have some other options such as if you want your terminal or theme background, you have true color, you can force TTY mode. We have our presets here. So this is our preset for how everything's laid out within BTOP. We have shown boxes. So this is everything that's shown from the get-go, which you can mess around with all this and change what is actually shown out of the actual menu. We have the update time, rounded corners, a couple more options here, background update, show battery, which for me I'll say false because this is a normal PC. If I hit 2, it will take me to the second menu, which is CPU. You can show the CPU bottoming and a bunch of different graph details. You do single layer graphs, check temp, true. If I go over to 3, we have all of our different memory settings. If I go 4, we have our network settings. And last but not least, 5 is our processor or processes setting. So if I escape out of this, this is BPYTOP. or not BPY top, this is now BTOP. So here is our CPU usage, and you can see all my cores, all my individual core temperatures, the current gigahertz speed of my CPU. And if I go over here, we have memory, disks, so we can see how much of our disks are being used, including my backup drive, the root disk and all that. We have our network, so our ongoing network speeds. We have our spikes, our lows, depending on what I loaded on the internet. And then over here, we have processes. And you can see with any section here, we have little slightly changed colors so we can see what our actual options are. So 2 for memory, 1 for CPU, 3 for net. And then right here, you could see I have other things highlighted. So A, Z, B, and N to switch them between different network cards. Over here under processes, I can go 4, which this will just get rid of the processes. I could go 3, I could go 2. If I really wanted to focus on just the CPU, or I could hit all those numbers just to bring everything back up again. And like if I only wanted to focus on processes, I'd go 1, 2, 3, and then I have all my processes here, and I could go through them, and if there was something I wanted to kill, which at the moment there is not, but down here we have options for info, terminate, kill, signals. So let's say I wanted to go up to OBS and see what's going on with that, I would just hit enter. And it would bring up an additional pane where it's going to tell me the actual utilization of this, how much memory this individual application is using and all that. If I hit enter, it's going to get rid of that. And then I can just go 1, 2, 3 and oh, there we go. 1, 2, 4 there, bring everything back up. It's a really beautiful tool and you can truly do a lot with it. Now, one thing I am going to note real quick is if you're as fond as applications like this as I am, I've done 2 different videos going over my list of favorite terminal-based applications, so go ahead and hit the button up there, or check out the links in the description if you're interested in that. Now, one thing you may notice real quick here is I have Audacity opened up, and the cool thing is we can actually filter through, so if I hit F, it's going to open up a little search thing, so I could type AUDA to find that specific process, and then I could hit enter and see exactly what this application's doing. I could highlight over it, hit K to kill it, and send the signal to kill that application, and you can see that application has been killed. So that's just a little example of how you can actually manage your open tasks and everything with this application. Overall, it's absolutely beautiful. I would highly recommend it to just about anybody on a Linux system. One, it looks absolutely beautiful just to have up and running somewhere on your screen. And 2, it's actually highly functional, highly configurable. If you check out their GitHub page, you'll see a list of all the different configuration options that you can change around either in the actual menu UI on here or through configuration files. So with all that said, I would like to thank our YouTube members and Patreon supporters, Mitchell Valentino, Philmat, Kyle, and Timo, Anthony, and all the other Techie and Techie Plus members. Thank you all so much for your support. It means the world to me. With all that said, once again, the links to everything I talked about, including those additional videos, will be in the description and probably pinned up on the comments somewhere down below. So with all that said, I do hope you have an absolutely beautiful day, and goodbye.